Hello and welcome back to Math Voyage 2024. Today we learn all about time, different types of clocks, timers and time, how we use them in our daily lives. The concept of seconds, minutes and hours, how to tell time using analog and digital clocks, understanding the time of the day for various activities, how to use an hourglass to measure the time it takes to complete an activity and compare which tasks take more or less time. Also, creating and interpreting a timeline using visuals. So stay tuned until the end of this video to master all these exciting aspects of time. Time is the way we measure passing of events. It helps us organize our day and plan our activities. Time also helps us measure the duration of events and keep track of our daily activities. Time is divided into two parts, daytime and nighttime. From sunrise to sunset, it is daytime, and from sunset to sunrise, it is nighttime. Time is measured in hours, minutes, and seconds. Second is the smallest standard unit of time. You can see here the red needle, which is moving very fast, is seconds. A day has 24 hours. From midnight to noon is called AM, and from noon to midnight is called PM. You will learn more about this later. A day is divided into four parts on a timeline. Timeline is like number line, but here we are dividing it into four parts. See the clock needles. How they are moving? They are moving in clockwise direction. For young learners and beginners, we'll divide it like this. 6 to 12, we say morning time. After sun rises and you wake up. Afternoon, 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. after lunch. Evening, 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. when the sun starts setting. And night is after dinner before bedtime. Here, see here, it is marked 6 a.m. to 12 p.m. it is marked morning. 12 p.m. to 4 p.m. is afternoon. 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. we call evening. And after 8 to again 6, it is night time. You can see the progression of the time from morning to night. You have just seen how a timeline shows progression of time from morning till night. Now here, this is a timeline. A timeline is a visual representation of events arranged in chronological order. It works like a number line with a start and an end. The starting point represents early morning, 6 a.m. and the ending point represents night, bedtime, 9 p.m. The divisions represent equal intervals of time hours. I have not marked them after 6 a.m., 7, 8, 9, it goes on like that. And now let us see the activities that you do. Morning activities, getting up at 6 a.m. Some are trying to get up and some are still nicely snoring. Then after you get up, brush your teeth, have breakfast, get ready for school. And 9, you go to school. And after that, afternoon, you have your lunch. Here one boy is trying to learn something. And 6 p.m. some take bath, some go for swimming. Elders like to have entertainment time, watching TV, listening to music, and after that have dinner and at night go to bed. The activities depend upon the school you are going, and also in each house it differs. So this is just an idea how it works. Let us try to learn the basics of measuring time using an analog clock. It is a 12-hour clock with numbers marked on it in clockwise direction. Now, units of time, seconds, minutes and hours, we learn with the help of analog clock. And as I told you before, the smallest standard unit of time is seconds. You can make an analog clock using cardboard. You have to write the numbers in clockwise direction. You can see here what I am doing. And you have 1 minute hand, which is long hand, and 1 hour hand, which is short hand. The green color one is the short hand. 60 seconds is 1 minute, 60 minutes is 1 hour, 24 hours is 1 full day. Stopwatch is used for seconds, an hourglass for hours, and here is a timer. How do we measure time? We use clocks and timers to measure time. Let's use analog clock and try to understand how to read time with shorthand hour hand and long minute hand. When the clock shows 6, that is shorthand is pointing towards 6 and long hand towards 12, we say it is 6 o'clock. And when the shorthand is pointing 1 and long hand 12, we say it is 1 o'clock. Similarly, when the short hand is pointing towards 2 and long hand 12, we say it is 2 o'clock. And short hand pointing 3 and long hand 12, we say it is 3 o'clock. Digital clocks display numbers. For example, 3 here means 3 o'clock. 12, like this, if it comes, it is 12 o'clock. Timers help measure short durations. The sand clock or hourglass. This is one of the oldest timekeeping devices. An hourglass is a special tool that uses sand to measure time. It has two glass sections connected by a tiny hole in the middle. The sand slowly falls from the top section to the bottom section through the hole. When all the sand has moved from top to bottom, a certain amount of time has passed. Here, right side is taking 5 seconds. You can then turn the hourglass over to start it again. Here is a daily routine given in picture form. You can pause the video and watch it. Morning routine, breakfast, school time, afternoon, lunch, evening activities, playtime, dinner, and night bedtime. Here again, you can see daily routine with time, learning to sequence daily events and routine. 6 o'clock wake up time, 7 o'clock breakfast, 9 o'clock office time, school time, and 10 o'clock refreshment time, 12 o'clock lunch time, 5 o'clock swimming, playing, reading books, 6 o'clock entertainment, 7 o'clock dinner, 9 o'clock bedtime. Now next is a very interesting topic, walking versus running. What takes more time? So let us see here, one boy is walking and the other is running. And what is the result? Walking is slower, takes more time. Running is faster than walking. Running is faster, takes less time. Walking takes the most time. Now next, cycling versus running. Here is one boy cycling and one boy is running. So again, what is the result? Cycling is faster than running. In this case, this is true. It need not be true always. So here, the minibus is the fastest. One more example. Here again, cycling is faster than running. Here is a recap. Time is measured in seconds, minutes, and hours. We use clocks and timers to measure time in daily life. There are different ways to represent time: analog, digital, 12-hour clock, 24-hour clock. All that you will learn later. So here you can again pause the video and watch this timeline. It is given in a different way. That's all in this video. The end. It is 12 o'clock. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And stay tuned for my next video on word problems on addition and subtraction of numbers up to 99. Bye. Take care.